welcome back to my channel. I hope you've had an amazing September, and as you can see by the title, I am bringing you another review. I will deliver another story time very soon. It's just that I've had problems with my left eye, so filming and editing and whatnot hasn't been, you know, yay high on the list. But I hope you're there. I hope you're here. I hope everything has been good and this September has been everything that you wanted and more. It was for me. Like, my birthday was just, it was perfect. Okay, it wasn't perfect, but it was good. It was really good. I have brought you guys a Maybelline Fit Me Great Lash and Baby Skin review. Alright, you may have seen these on your timeline and everything because every influencer has been raving about the Fit Me and how good the coverage of this product is and everything, you know. But I mean, let's try it out. Let's see where you should spend your coin and whatnot, you know. But the first thing I use is the Baby Skin Pore Eraser. I use this as a primer when I'm using the Maybelline range because, honestly and truly speaking, when I went out to the store and spent my coin on these products, I wanted to use everything Maybelline, you know. And just to factor in how good Maybelline's products work with each other instead of mixing and matching and whatnot, so that I could give you guys an honest review, okay? But yeah, so the Baby Skin is an instant pore eraser. It's similar to the pore filler, the NYX pore filler, NYX Cosmetics pore filler. It's much more reasonable, but it's also smaller, way smaller. But yeah, I cover usually my nose area underneath my eyes because that's where my pores say hello, dumela, hi. And yeah, I honestly enjoy how smooth it is when you apply it on the skin. It's amazing. It feels really smooth. The texture is soft, creamy, and yeah, I enjoy it. I really do enjoy it. I do use it with my other foundations as well, but yeah. Anyways, gotta cover that. So the next thing I like to do is just let it sit for about 5 minutes and then go in with my foundation. The next thing I will do is use my Fit Me foundation in the shade 355. Obviously shades vary if you want to buy yourself a foundation tab. Go into the store and see which shade works well with your skin. You obviously need to factor in the fact that it oxidizes, and yeah. Okay, I don't use that much. I just use a small piece and then we move on with life. But yeah, when I first applied, it's like orange and everything. But as I blend it in and spread it around the skin, it becomes or leans towards my skin color. And to be quite honest with you guys, I actually prefer orange foundation over the yellow grayish foundation. Oh, bear in mind y'all, I really haven't done my brows, so yeah, my way of doing things is a little different. Because I like doing my foundation first and then the eyes, and depending on how I do my makeup, if it spills, I'd rather dust it off with powder than to have the fear of potentially wiping off my foundation while doing my eyes, you know. Okay, so if you follow me on Instagram, you might have seen how I do my makeup prep and whatever, and how I use these products when I got a PR package for this specific campaign. But yeah, the fact that I actually went out to buy it means I actually like it. And yeah. Oh, and by the way, whenever I am using a sponge, I like to wet it with a prime or prepping spray, you know, instead of water. I don't know, it feels much better for me. Because I just feel like with water it's kind of pointless because I'm basically wiping everything off. But yeah, with foundation I like natural looking coverage. So I don't go for heavy coverage because I don't have that many dark spots on my face. Okay, and there we go. See, it has become less orange, more brown. And the next thing I go in with, excuse me, my concealer looks a little ratchet. I don't know why the concealer packaging just goes away. I don't understand why it fades. I really don't. You even question yourself and ask yourself if you bought the real thing. But anyways, so I usually use two shades of concealer, but when I first got this package, I got the 355 concealer, and I've grown to liking only using one concealer, especially with this range. So yeah, we're gonna conceal under the eyes and the chin area and the forehead area. Forehead, however you say it. I say forehead because my dad. And I'll go back in with a sponge, a different sponge this time. Oh, I keep my sponges in a Ziploc, makes my life much easier. My beauty blender looks so crusty, you guys. I have others in here, but anyways, spray it with a fixing spray or a setting spray and just dab it out. You can already see the difference on how I already, like, under my eye, that little eye bag that I have forming there, I don't know from what, has disappeared. It's gone, like, it has said goodbye. And yeah, I don't usually bake, but lately I have been baking the hell out of everything. So I couldn't find a baking or translucent powder where I went, and so I'm going to use a different translucent powder. Not gonna show what it is because it's kind of pointless if I'm doing an all Maybelline video to show a different product. But yeah, I bake with two different shades, you guys. The lighter shade first underneath, and then the more orange slash yellowy shade on top. Sometimes I mix the white translucent powder with an orangey translucent powder. I don't know, it works for me. Yes, I bake my chin too. And the forehead. Because if you conceal your forehead, then it's... you. I know some people don't get it, but I do. That's all that matters. Okay, now I'm going in with my second translucent powder slash fixing powder, which you can see is way, way, way more orange than the one I used. Yeah, so you wait 5 minutes. You don't talk to me. Okay, so after 5 minutes has lapsed, you're going to use a foundation powder to dust off the translucent powder. And I have used the Maybelline Matte Porelss powder in the shade 355 Cinnamon. It does look a little light, but everything can be fixed. You just take a little bit and just dust it off. Okay, and if you do it correctly, you shouldn't need to further contour your face by adding a darker concealer, because by lightening certain areas of your face, you've already enhanced the darkest parts of your face, right? And another thing I like to do just after I've baked the most important features on my face, I bake right here, just under the contour line for your cheekbones. I already have high cheekbones, so it doesn't require that much time to set and whatnot. Guys, this is my first like makeup type of tutorial review type thing, and it's exciting. He's exciting. Because also some MUA artists decide that, because also some MUAs decide that we all understand the face anatomy and all of that bash guava, and they just whiz past everything. Like when you were in class doing your thing, girl, I wasn't with you. Why you assume that I know? Like we don't understand, we can't can. No, cut crease and this, they don't even explain what the crease is. You just have to know that there's a crease there, like honestly and truly. Like bar leka, hey? So yeah, like just like that, without using a darker concealer shade, you have contour. How cool is that? Okay, and then we obviously need to spray. Where's my spray? I usually use bigger sprays, but I like pouring, so I'll buy bigger fixing sprays and just pour them in here for convenience and for my bag just to travel with. But yeah, spray a generous amount and then you'll go in with your blender just to make sure. Wow, that is not okay. That shouldn't happen to you. See, I didn't do what I usually do. Out here telling you that I usually wait for the But yeah, you just go in with your blender to make it look more natural. You get me? Because you don't want to be out here looking like Sophie can lick the foundation off your face. I need to cut my eyebrows. They're super bushy. Like, I don't even understand. Like, how did we get to this point, Maki? Like, how, Sophie? Anyways, so once you are done with this, you would then go on to apply your highlighter, this, that. I couldn't find the Chrome Master, if I've said it correctly, the Chrome Master Maybelline highlighter, but I found an alternative and I will show that in my September faves video. But anyways, now the great lash. This product has been said to be a miracle. It apparently changes your eyebrows for the greater good of mankind, or whatever nonsense I'm saying. But yeah, guys, before I do this, my eyebrows are a problem. They are super curly. It is a whole fern or vine situation going on in here, so I really just opt for fake lashes and let's be great with life. Because if I had to sit and mascara my eyelashes, I would sit here for an hour. Done it before where I sat and I curled mascara, and I ended up sitting here for like an hour until I got the result that I wanted. Anyways, so just gonna use this, and to be quite honest, apart from one of my fave mascaras that I usually use from another brand, this has fast worked its way into my favorite makeup product. Because even though it doesn't do my lashes justice, you can still see the difference. I mean, what's up, y'all? Anyways, so it does make a difference, and this is really good if you already have lashes that aren't curly, because it just defines the F out of your lashes. But yeah, this Betty, this Goosey has the curliest lashes on planet Z. So, anyways, but sure. So, the next thing I'm going to do is just fix my brows and untraumatize you guys. Okay, so I am back. Everything's done. I just added a bit of highlighter because, you know, the Goosey cannot be looking plain. And me and highlighter are like, you get what I'm saying? But all in all, I actually love the light to medium coverage that I get from the foundation. And I like how you can see the difference in the brightness of the skin as soon as you're finished using the concealer. And I really like how the powder, how I use the powder first of all when dusting off the translucent powder, and how it doesn't give me that whole gray outline. It's amazing for me. Okay, so the great lash, guys. I think it would be great if God had decided to just bless me with eyebrows this soft. I understand, like fans, you know, that just blow people away. But he was like, nope, you're already doing the most with your height, let me just. But it's cool. I do see the difference after I've applied it. It just doesn't give me that wow effect like I expected, because I watched a million and one videos about it and I saw everybody's lashes going from this to false lash vibes, you know. But all in all, I think it's a great product. It really is. And the primer, super creamy. The texture is just creme de la creme. Oh, shabakari, rem, rem, rem. I understand. Like, wow. And overall, I'm happy with my full face of Maybelline products. I gave the Maybelline range a 9 out of 10. I think the one point that's missing is this is a my country problem. It has nothing to do with Maybelline, because I'm pretty sure if I was on the stage right now, I could have found a really nice highlighter. I could have found a brow pencil that I liked, you know, and everything that I needed, instead of walking into a store and them telling me, I'm out of stock ganjani monkey, but it's fine. Anyways, thank you guys for watching my review. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you know where you can spend your coin and spend it wisely. And to those of you who are new, please don't forget to subscribe. And if you like the video, like. If you have constructive criticism, please do leave a comment in the comment section down below. Love you guys, and I will see you super, super, super soon. Love and light. But you won't let me in, you don't talk to me, you're too big. I'd recommend that you go in store, use the testers to see which skin works well with